process from concept to completion?
Usually, it is get a photo of the wall. Then sit on it for a while.
Huh?
Honestly, sometimes I ask the wall, I don't ask the wall just tells me what it wants. And then part of that evolves in the process. And then I'll have lots of ideas in my head. Sometimes I'll sketch it. Then I'll do a lot of stuff on my iPhone. There's incredible apps now that you can basically do anything on it. And then I'll get some graphic design help because it takes me a long time to work in that software. Some people are just quicker, like Tyler.
Sometimes the design evolves. I add extra colors like I did to this. I reposition it because it's gonna be better visually and aesthetically.
But it'll never be something completely different. It won't be like, hey, it's a pink unicorn, and all of a sudden there's like a gray whale. That's basically the process. It's the ad-lib version.
How does it feel to have a canvas this size?
Sometimes it's a little daunting. Sometimes you look at it and you're like, oh God, how many days am I gonna spend here? How long is it gonna take? And I respect it. And I honor it. And I take it very seriously. Have I ever doubted myself? All the time. Every single day, every time I'm doing something new. And that's just, that's me. That's me being me. Some of my internal triggers and voices and things like that are, what's it gonna look like? How are people gonna think? Learning to surrender. So it's definitely opened me up to more of that. But yeah, every time I'm always, could it be better? I'm always down. I did this zoo collaboration with a buddy. And that morning I woke up when they were gonna auction off the piece and I look over at my fiance. And I'm like, you think this is really gonna sell for something? Is it gonna make an impact?
9,500, let's go to 10,000 right now. 10,000 right there. 16,000. 17 right there.
$40,000, there we go. That's what I'm talking about.
If that's not a, you know, testament to A, you're doing the right thing, B, even if you doubt yourself, others are still believing in you. So, you know, it's still okay to doubt yourself. Just never stop, never quit, and never think you can't.
Take it out for the West Side. Door to door. Door to OGs. Door to low. Door to insane.
Social media has been a very powerful tool for artists, for people in general. And every day I wake up to some really cool, awesome posts. And it's the highlight of my day. It's actually what fuels me and continues me down doing this and saying yes and continuing to paint and share messages. And I want to be tagged in everyone's post because I want to hear what people are sharing. I want to hear what they're saying. I want to know what it meant to them. Honestly, I'm inspired by how the community reacts to my work. How's that wall taking the paint?
It's really dry. We're gonna need a bunch of coats.
Oh.
Maybe you'd like to come back and help again.
Following your dreams is literally one of the most important things that you as a human has the opportunity to do. You have the opportunity to single-handedly change the world in any capacity. And that doesn't mean if you don't create world peace, you haven't done anything. But if you made a difference just in your household, being a mother, being a father, or being a friend, that's important.
game is mine. I'ma spell my name one more time. Check it. It's the N-O-T-O-R-I-O-U-S.
This is hydration time. Did you get taller?
Yeah.
In the house of blues, I'm going back to Cali. I'm going back to Cali.
So I use my work as a statement or an opportunity. I also like to say it's an invitation for the viewer to interact with it. I do not have any very specific in-your-face social or political or agenda behind it. But, you know, I do have subtle things in there. I use color for when I write love all over the place, because at the end of the day, we're all different colors. We all love differently. There's no right or wrong way how to love. You know, humans don't come with instructions. Parents do the best thing that they can. So that's all about living in color and loving in color and knowing that we're all different but the same. Sometimes I use black and white backgrounds. That's, you know, a little subliminal nod to still the divide between black and white. But then I put the color on top of it, and again, love unites and love heals and love rises. And at the end of the day, we're all the same on the inside. So why not live the best lives we can?
When we come around.
Thank you for bringing Love Rises to life. I love it. You made a magnificent piece of art. And I'm going to give you a piece of advice from an older woman who's lived a while. The wedding pictures are going to last forever. You're not going to want these in them.
Thank you for interacting with my art. It's an open invitation for you to take it in however you see fit, to make it do what it does for you in your life. What you say and how it impacts you, I wouldn't be doing this. It's really the fuel that keeps me going. And I love waking up every day and reading how it's affecting this city and places all around the world. So thank you very much.